respire to this. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yeah. let's continue worshiping the Lord once more this morning. The presence of the Lord is in this place. Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. Lord, we give you glory. Lord, we thank you, Lord Almighty God. Hallelujah. 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 It's never too late to worship and praise Him. It's never too late, hallelujah, to call upon His name. It's never too late, hallelujah, to seek the face of the Lord. Hallelujah, I want to say, I'm glad because I'm in the house of the Lord. I'm glad because I'm in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. As the choir was singing, when I call His name, brothers and sisters, when you're in problem, the first person you reach to sometimes, as we are being directed by our mind, is our neighbor. Hallelujah. And this morning, the song that speaks to us, when I call His name. When I call His name, hallelujah. Just call on the name of us. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. It's very first time. I believe each and every one of us, we have a need. We have a petition. We have something that we need to speak on unto Jesus. And this morning, I want to tell you, I want to assure you, you never leave this place the same way you came. Hallelujah. As we see on the screen, they have displayed our prayer request this morning. We are going to pray for Pastor, my brothers and sisters. If you pray for the pastor and his family, this is the servant whom the Lord has called just to feed us with His word. And this morning, I just want us to remember Pastor and his family. And also we are going to pray for our building. Remember the children of Israel when in the tabernacle, they used to just to shift the tabernacle. They will walk with it, leave it somewhere. But this time I want to tell you, in this dispensation of grace, we are blessed with a building. There's somewhere we can gather, we can close the door, we can shout, we can sing, we can call upon the name of the Lord. And I need us just to pray for this building. Just pray that the Lord will provide for our building. Hallelujah. And also, we are here in this land of Greece. Each and every one of us, if you look back, we have our history. We have where we are coming from. We have where we send our money to support our families. That is back home. But we are in this land. We did not come by accident. The Lord brought us here in Greece with a purpose. Sometimes our hearts, my brothers and sisters, pains when we see them, when fire is raging upon this land. We have seen what has been happening on television. We have seen the firemen just sleeping on the road. There's one thing we cannot get back, and that is life. Building we can get back. Hallelujah. The houses that burns, they can get back. But what about life? So remember, you are a child of God. In this land, you are standing in the gap. You are standing in the gap. Pray for the country of Greece. Pray for the leaders who are in authority in this land of Greece, that the Lord also will give them wisdom on how to lead us. Pray for the prime minister. Pray for each and every government position that is being as a symbol that is there just to bless us. Let the Lord bless them. Let the Lord use them. Hallelujah. And also, we are going to pray for COVID-19 healing. It was pandemic, just like a wakening call to all of us. We have seen that a third of the world has passed. But thank God you are standing here today. You are rejoicing in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We are standing. It's a testimony, just an unspoken testimony that you are here. We can see you. Just remember to pray for those who are affected by COVID-19, that the Lord will stretch His able hands and touch each and every families, each and every country that is affected with this COVID-19. And also, as we stand here, each and every one of us, we represent a family. There are family members we have in our families, our brothers, our sisters, our uncles. They don't know Jesus. And this morning, just speak their name unto the Lord. Leave the rest unto the Lord. You just call upon the name of the Lord. Remember your families. And also in our church, we have the ministers, our leaders, we have ministerial teams, we have elders, we have many, many bodies in the house of God. But these bodies, we are fitly joined together for the work of the kingdom. As a child of God, remember to pray for all our leaders, and Ekete ministers. I believe without praying for our needs, sometimes it's good to remember others. Turn your prayers not to be mine, but Lord, our. Amen. And the Lord will bless us. Hallelujah. Church, I want where you are, just raise your voice together as we pray for these needs. Hallelujah. Jesus, we thank you this morning. We bless your name, Lord and mighty God. As we call upon your name, Lord Jesus, we commit our pastor and his family and your evil hearts, Lord. Lord Almighty, where they are, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Supply unto them, Lord. Provide unto them, Lord. Use them mightily, Lord. We cover them with the precious blood of Jesus. We cover them this morning with the precious blood of Jesus. Anoint your servant more and more. Hallelujah, Lord, as we pray as the church this morning. Lord Almighty God, we declare and decree that no weapon formed against them shall prosper. No weapon formed against our party, pastors, and this family shall prosper. Lord, hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Use them mightily, Lord. Bless them, King of Kings. We give you glory, Lord Almighty God. Hallelujah for the land of Greece, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for bringing us here to this land, Lord. We thank you, King of Kings, Lord Almighty God. We cry unto you, Lord Almighty God. Open the floodgates of heaven. Hallelujah. Let your flood rains on this land. Floods of blessing, Lord. Floods of peace, King of Kings. Hallelujah. There will be no more fire, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord, give them peace of mind, Lord. Hallelujah, comfort them, Lord, hallelujah, who are affected with this fire, Lord. Jesus, we give you glory, Lord Almighty God. We thank you for our families, Lord. We thank you, Lord Almighty God. The good work have begun our families, oh Lord. Lord Almighty God, use our families, Lord. Speak unto them, Lord. Hallelujah, those who don't know you, Lord. Let your spirit quicken them, Lord. Let your spirit quicken them, Lord Jesus. We give you glory, Lord. We give you honor, Lord. As we remember also pandemic, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. The countries that are affected with COVID-19, Lord. Let your spirit rain upon these lands, Lord. Heal them, Lord, those who are sick, Lord. Heal them, those who are sick, Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you for the stopping the spread of COVID-19, Lord. We give you glory, Lord. We thank you, Lord Almighty God. We honor you, Lord Almighty God. Also for our ministers, our leaders, Lord. Hallelujah. Our elders, King of Kings. We give you glory, Lord, for the Ekete Church, Lord. Ekete brothers, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Use them mightily, Lord. Anoint them, Lord. Anoint them, Lord. Hallelujah. Shikarabasokoreshapayamalaba. Father, we thank you. We thank you, Jesus. We give you glory. We give you honor. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Give a hand up to Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Before we sit down, I just want to take your time a little bit, just emphasizing, hallelujah, on giving unto the Lord. We may delight ourselves in different things. You can sit down, you may sit down, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You may delight on many things. Delight on our businesses. Delight on many areas that will benefit us and our families. But let me tell you, the Bible speaks well in Psalm 37, verse 4. And it's telling us, it's there on the board, delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desire of thine heart. That's what we call mission. There are people in this world, they don't know Jesus. As we give into mission, remember that you are making, you are bringing a soul into the kingdom. There's someone reaching that soul. As we invest that to get profit. As a businessman, he never calculates his profit for one day, but he calculates in a year. After a year, substantially, what have I received? Praise the Lord. Because as a businessman, sometimes you check that only 5 euro. I cannot open my business because of 5. But you check annually, after 12 months, what will I get? Is it enough for me to sell this product? Praise the Lord. And we find ourselves that we drive our minds to that area. But this morning, I want you to drive your mind as telling you that let's invest in the kingdom of God. Let's invest in the kingdom of God. You may have little, but in the eyes of God is much. Praise the Lord. As we give, remember, there's a soul that needs to hear the word of God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Giving time, blessing time. Giving time,
blessing
time. Giving time, blessing time. I just want us, hallelujah, to pray for our offering. The Bible says, give and it shall come back to you. In good measure, pressed down, shaken and running over. And this morning, as we give, we are giving unto the Lord. Let's just pray together. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, once again, we say thank you for providing unto us. Thank you for the jobs you have offered for us. Thank you for all the blessings, Lord. Lord, we cannot count our blessings, King of Kings. Lord, as we give unto you, Lord Almighty God, we ask you, Lord Jesus, remember them also who don't have, Lord. Provide unto them. Lord, we give for the glory, Lord Almighty God, of your name and for the work of your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's give unto the Lord.
You are God. I will be still. I will be still. our country, he's still on the throne. He says, be still and see that I am God. Who can testify that? Be still and know that I am God. Praise the Lord. It's time for announcement to may sit down for a while. Praise the name. Who like the church how it is? It's nice? It's very nice. Me, I like it. But Sister Mandy and the team, they have something they want to do in the church after the service. So today, after the service, whoever is willing can stay and help Sister Mandy and her team, because they're going to remove this black thing and going to make this place make more nice. So anyone who is willing to stay after the service, please join Sister Mandy, because she needs a helping hand. Praise the Lord. We have one more announcement from Sister Norma. Those who have ordered for the t-shirt, please see Sister Norma. She has a few t-shirts more. So whoever has ordered, please see her. And those who have not paid, we need you to pay for that money, because there were some for the project. And one of the projects was to fix the here in the pulpit and to fix there in the drums. So we need that money. So if you can, you can see Sister Norma. We have also Sister Wayne. She came back. The last time she was in Paris, and she was seeing that we are praying for her, but we thank the Lord that she's back in Crossroad. Welcome, Sister Wayne. We have all from a new guest from Sister Susan Kemos, Sister Mendlin England from Philippines. Welcome to the house of the Lord. We hope that you come again. And then our usual announcement, every Wednesday we have Bible study. Please come and let us, all of us, stick together and let us seek the Lord all together. And on Saturday we have prayer. We have a good feeling when we are joined together in prayer. When we come here in prayer, we feel this place filled with His presence. So join us every Saturday, 7:30, and every Wednesday. Come and let us join hands all together. And on Sunday, we have a service. The Lord has not gone to summer, let me tell you. It may be time for holiday, but the Lord never goes to holiday. He's still here. Don't say it's summer, it's time to rest. The Lord is not resting. Come to the house of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Let us come and let us see what the Lord can do for us. Praise the name of the Lord. Today, it is me I'm going to give the word today. So I need for all of you to pray for me. It was, let's say, a last minute decision was not supposed to be me. But by the grace of God, the Lord is going to do something. Let us pray. Oh Lord Jesus, I give you all the glory, I give you all the honor, Father. Thank you for your name, thank you for your everything, Lord. I lay myself in your hands, oh Lord Jesus. I'm opening my heart, oh Lord, to receive from you, oh Lord Jesus. Use me, anoint me, oh Lord Jesus, for your word, oh Lord Jesus. I give you all the glory, Father, for there is none like you. Thank you for your everything, thank you for who you are. I give you all the glory for the one who's going to hear today, oh Lord. Let that word come in our heart, oh Lord Jesus, and stick, oh Lord Jesus. I give you all the praise, Father, for there is none like you. I worship and give you all the praise. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray and give thanks. Can you clap our hands unto the Lord? Praise the Lord. I'm going to tell you the topic of my preaching for today is beyond the wall. We all face a wall one time in our lives. Sometimes we face some walls which we don't have the power to put them down. In the Bible, we have so many who have found themselves in front of the walls, but they had the Savior with them. So tonight, I want to see one of them. Can we stand for the reading of the word? I'm sorry, I'm going to tell you from now, but I'm going to read a very long story, so bear with me a little bit. In Joshua 6, 1 to 11. Now Jericho was strictly shut up because of the children of Israel. None went out and none came in. And the Lord said unto Joshua, see, I have given unto thy hand Jericho, and the king therefore, and the mighty men of Elon. and ye shall compass the city, all ye men of war, and go around about the city once. Thou shalt do 6 days. And 7 priests shall bear before the ark 7 trumpets of ram's horns. And the 7th day ye shall compass the city 7 times, and the priests shall blow with the trumpet. And it shall come to pass that when they make a long blast with the ram horn, and when ye hear the sound of the trumpet, all the people shall shout with a great shout, and the wall of the city shall fall down flat, and the people shall accept up every man straight before him. And Joshua the son of Nun called the priests and said unto them, take up the ark of the covenant, and let 7 priests bear 7 trumpets of ram horns before the ark of the Lord. And he said unto the people, pass on and compass the city, and let him that is armed pass on before the ark of the Lord. And it came to pass, when Joshua he spoken unto the people, that 7 priests bearing 7 trumpets of ram horn passed on before the Lord and blew with the trumpet, and the ark of the covenant of the Lord followed them. And the armed men went before the priest and blow with the trumpet, and the reward came. After the ark, the priests go on and blowing with the trumpet. And Joshua had commanded the people, say, ye shall not shout, not make any noise with your voice, neither shall any word proceed out of your mouth until the day I bid you to shout, and then shall ye shout. So the ark of the Lord compassed the city, going about it once, and they came unto the camp and longed for the camp. Let us jump and go to number 15. And it came to pass on the 7th day that they rose early about the dawning of the day and compassed the city after the same manner 7 times. Only on that day they compassed the city 7 times. Number 16. 16. And it came to pass on the 7th day, on the 7th time, when the priest blew the trumpet, Joshua said unto the people, shout, for the Lord hath given you the city. And let's go number 17. And the city shall be accursed, even it and all that therein, for the Lord, only Rahab the harlot shall live, she and all that are in her in the house, because she hid the messenger that we sent. And ye in any wise keep thyself from the accused thing, lest ye make thyself accused. When ye take of the accused thing, and make the camp of Israel a curse, a trouble it, but all the silver, the gold, and the vases of the brass and nylon are concentrated unto the Lord, they shall come in the treasury of the Lord. So the people shouted when the priests blew the trumpet, and came to pass, when the people heard the sound of the trumpet, and the people shouted with a great shout, that the wall fell down flat, so that the people went up into the city, every man straight before him, and they took the city. And they utterly destroyed all that was in the city, both man, woman, young and old, and ox, and sheep, and ass, and the edges with the edges of the sword. Praise the name of the Lord. Can we clap to the word of the Lord? You may see them. We all know about the children of Israel, how they came to Egypt. We know the story of Joseph, how he was betrayed by his brothers, and he went to be sold as a slave so he can go to Egypt. When he went there, he passed through many things until he reached Pharaoh's house. When he was Pharaoh's house, he interpreted the dream of Pharaoh, and he became the second in command. Now when the hunger came, the children of Israel came, all of them to Israel, to Egypt. That's how the children of Israel and the Israel, all of them, immigrated to Egypt. Egypt was not their land. It was the land that they came to be saved from the salvation. But as the years passed, when Joseph passed away, became the oppression. The Pharaoh changed and became the one who was seeing them as a threat. He started making them slaves, he started doing something bad to them. So they cried unto the Lord. As we were singing, we were saying, when we were in trouble, we cried to the Lord. So the Israelites, they cried unto the Lord. And the Lord heard them there, and he sent Moses to come and rescue them. But their rescue was not easy because they had lost their faith on the Lord. So when they reached in the sea, they were like telling the Moses, you remove us from Egypt so we can come and die here in the sea. But there Moses made the first big miracle. He stood up with the rod up and he said, stand still, and this is the salvation of the Lord. And the sea opened and they walked on a dry land. No, how many people have seen the sea open and see a dry land? I think none of us. But they saw it. They went on a dry land. And when the Egyptians came to pass, the sea came back and killed of them. And that was the last day that they saw the Egyptians or the oppression. But the children of Israel, they have seen a lot of miracles the Lord has done for them. The Lord has given them food, manna every day without working, without doing anything. Every morning they were waking up and they were seeing food. How many of us do we wake up in the morning and we see food out of our doors? We don't see, but the Lord is providing. But for them, it was every morning they had fresh manna. Praise the name of the Lord. And when they didn't have, in the desert, they didn't have water, out of a rock came water. The children of Israel have seen great miracles. They have seen a lot of things that the Lord has done for them. But as people, they were not trusting the Lord. Sometimes even us, the Lord can do a miracle for us, but when something else happens, we start complaining, we start searching for something else. But we forget the miracles that the Lord has done for us. But He is a merciful God. Even with all of that, He's still able to do another miracle for us. Praise the name of the Lord. In the wilderness there, the Lord has promised the children of Israel for a land full of milk and honey. What is milk and honey? With everything that you desire. With everything that you had that you want. That was the milk and honey. And the children of Israel were saying, oh, that's very good. But when Moses sent the 12 spies to go and see the land, 10 of them came with a bad report. They didn't see the promises the Lord has given to them. The Lord, He didn't say, you go on and conquer. He didn't say, you go and fight. He said, I'm going to give you a land of milk and honey. He didn't say that you're going to do anything. He said, I'm going to give you. The Lord was providing to them something, but they were like, oh, I see the giant. We are seeing this. They are huge. We cannot go before them. So they were complaining. So out of the 12, they came back to Moses. 10, they came with a negative report. Only 2 came with a positive report. And those 2, they saw what the Lord can do. Praise the name of the Lord. But when the 10 went out, their negativity spread like fire all over the camp. And all of them, they came with the negative. No, we cannot go. No, we cannot go. It's very hard. We see walls. We see the giant. We cannot pass. Even us like that is where we do. Sometimes you can have a problem and the Lord is telling you just go on. But you hear the people next to you say, oh, it's difficult. Instead of trusting the Lord, you're trusting the people. Let us trust the Lord. Does not matter how big the wall is. Does not matter what you're going through. The Lord is able to do it if He say you're going to go through it. Praise the name of the Lord. You know, most of the time we see things with our physical eyes. We see the world the way we see with the eyes. Everybody is, we have eyes, but the Lord wants us to see with our spiritual eyes. We see beyond. It's time to see beyond the world. It's time to see beyond what we can see. Praise the name of the Lord. Joshua and Caleb saw with the spiritual eyes. They saw the giant. They saw the walls. They saw everything other people they saw. But because they trust in the Lord, and said, and the Lord was with them, and they opened their spiritual eyes, and they remember the promise the Lord has given them. They say, we can do it. We can possess this land. Praise the name of the Lord. And when Moses passed away and Joshua came to be the leader of the church, he was a praying man. He was a man who was after God. In everything he was calling the Lord. So when he came, when he took to be the leader of Israel, he still continued seeking the Lord. And as they, after 40 years of going round in the desert, the Lord opened the way for them to go into the promised land. And we see the first thing they encounter is the River Jordan. You remember when they were leaving Egypt, they found the Red Sea. Now, to go to river, to enter to the Canaan, they found another river in front of them. Praise the name of the Lord. The Lord wants to ensure the people that the way he was with Moses is the same way he is with Joshua. So we read in Joshua 4, 22 and 24. Praise the name of the Lord. Then he shall let your children know, saying, Israel, come over this Jordan on dry land. He promised them that they're going to walk again in a dry land. Remember, it's a sea, but the Lord has promised them to walk in a dry land. For the Lord your God dried up the waters of Jordan from before you until ye passed over, as the Lord your God did to the Red Sea, which he dried up before us, until we were gone over. That all the people of the earth might know the hand of the Lord, that he is mighty, and ye might fear the Lord your God forever. Praise the name of the Lord. Our Lord is great. He told them to come in the ark, and when they stepped, the priest, as they carried the ark, stepped in the river will dry up. The river will split the same way as he split in Red Sea. The Lord, he is a merciful God. The children, all these people has disobeyed the Lord, but the Lord still wants them to give whatever he has promised. Your promises, the Lord, whatever the Lord promises unto you, he's going to give you. It's you who will make the journey short or long. The children of Israel, they make their journey very long until a full generation passed away. Can you imagine? The Lord has promised you something, but is your children going to eat those fruit because of your disobedience? Praise the name of the Lord. We see the Lord want to ensure the children of Israel that all the other, there'll be fearful of them. And we read in Joshua 5 and 1. And it came to pass, when all the kings of the Amorites, which were on the side of the Jordan went side, and all the kings of Canaanites, which were by the sea, heard that the Lord had dried up the water of Jordan from before the children of Israel, until we are passed over, that their heart melted, neither their spirit in them anymore because of the children of Israel. The Lord, when he gives you something, he's going to make the way. Praise the name of the Lord. You know, sometimes we see difficult and we don't know how to pass it. You see here that the Lord already melted the hearts of the enemy. The enemy, they don't have strength to fight. It's like you have a battle in front of you and you think these people are mighty and strong, but already the Lord has destroyed their strength, because we are serving a mighty God. So never fear when a war comes before you. Praise the name of the Lord. And the children of Israel, they passed again another sea on a dry land. But still, they had a doubt about the Lord. They came to a mighty city. The first city they came to conquer, it was Jericho. Jericho was known as a mighty city with a great wall, a very big wall that nobody could ever pass. But the Lord has told them, I have given you the city already. That's what we read in the beginning. I have given you the city. To the Lord, does not matter what is in front of you. Does not matter what comes in front of you. Does not matter what the enemy has planned for you. What he has promised, it will come to pass. Praise the name of the Lord. And we read that in Joshua, as we read before, that nobody was going in or coming out without their permission. It was a great city. But there, Joshua went to the near king and called it upon the name of the Lord. And the angel of the Lord came and spoke to him again. And he sent two spies to go and see the city. And they went and they saw and they came and bring a message to Joshua. And Joshua went to the Lord and inquired, and the Lord gave him what we read. I have given you thy hand Jericho and the king therefore and the mighty men of Israel. He has given everything, the city, the king, and all their mighty men. So never be afraid of the world that's before you. We sang the song here that we walk above the sea. That's what we are. When you are with the Lord, you are walking always above the sea. You can walk and you not go down because you're trusting in the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. As long as Peter was looking at Jesus, his mind was focused on Jesus, was not sinking. When he started seeing the storms, he started seeing the surrounding, is the time that he started drowning, going down. But there the hands of the Lord pulled him and hold him and kept him up. So even you, when you're going in trouble, when you're going in anything you're going, just let your focus be unto the Lord. Let your mind and everything you have be unto the Lord. He's the Alpha and the Omega, the finisher of our faith. Praise the name of the Lord. Many times we pray, but we don't get answer. Or we don't get answer the way we want. We pray, Lord, remove this mountain. Lord, do this or do that. But the Lord has another plans. The Lord has other plans in his mind. He wants you to go through the wall. He doesn't want to remove the wall. If he wanted, he could have removed all that great wall and the city, so the children of Israel to go through. But he wanted them to see how mighty God it is. So he told them, just walk. I don't want you to fight. I want you to walk. Can you imagine you have an enemy in front of you? And you, the only thing you can do is just walking. Mm-hmm. And you don't talk. Can you imagine? That's how the Lord wants. He does not want to do difficult things. He wants to do the simple thing. So they were told to go for 6 days just walking. Only the trumpet will be shouting. Nobody will say anything. Now nobody will open his mouth. Praise the name of the Lord. But you know why he shut their mouth? Because the first time when they spoke, they saw negativity. The first time when the spies were sent, they saw negativity, and that negativity spread like fire between themselves. This time the Lord said, no, nobody will speak. They will just see. They will just see my able hands do the work. Praise the name of the Lord. And for 6 days, they were just going around, no speaking, no nothing. They were told nobody even speak anything. So the Lord wanted everybody to just close their mouth and see what the Lord can do. And on the seventh day, they were told, now we will walk 7 times. You know, if you go and see the map, the town of Jericho was not a small town. It was a big town. It was a great city. So, can you imagine the people in the city seeing people just walking for 6 days? They were like, what they are doing? But the Lord had a plan. The Lord had a plan. On the seventh day, they were told, walk 7 times. And on the seventh time, shout, for the Lord has given us the city. He didn't say the Lord will give us the city. He said the Lord has given, he has already given the city. The city, it was under their foot already. Praise the name of the Lord. We need to believe before we see. We need able to believe that the Lord is able to do whatever he says before we see the miracle. Praise the name of the Lord. We need to have that faith that I'm already healed, even though I'm not feeling well. Praise the name of the Lord. I have a financial problem, but I believe that the Lord already have solved the problem because He's a mighty God, I have a say so. Praise the name of the Lord. Whatever you're going through, believe that the Lord already has done it. Praise the name of the Lord. We need to believe before we see. We don't need to be like Thomas who said, I need to see the Lord and put my hand. The Lord said, blessed is the people who will not see and believe. We need first to believe that the Lord can do it, and then the miracle will come on the way. Praise the name of the Lord. The blind man that was, they were healed, the Lord spit down and put the ashes in the eyes. He was told, go and wash yourself and you'll see. He didn't ask how or what will happen. He believed that he already has seen. Let us believe that the Lord can do whatever He said. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. So on the seventh day, they went around. They went around, and on the shout of the trumpet, they shout that the Lord has given us the city. With that faith that the Lord has already given us the city. Imagine for 6 days you have not speak anything. People have seen you. But on the seventh day, you have proclaimed victory. You are proclaiming that you have seen the city has fallen down. But you have not seen it. But you have believed that the Lord, because He has said, He's going to do it. So when they shout the city, they have they shout that the Lord has given us the city, the walls just fall down. Because nothing can stand in the able hands of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. When the Lord was in the sea and the storm rise, He just spoke and the storm just cooled down. Praise the name of the Lord. When Lazarus was dead, He just spoke and Lazarus rise up. By the word of the Lord, anything can change. There is nothing the Lord cannot do by His word. Praise the Lord. He created us by His word. Praise the name of the Lord. So when we pray first and seeking the Lord, let us believe that all walls can fall even before we see them. Let us believe that we can see the able hands of the Lord even before we reach there. Praise the name of the Lord. I want to see, we see something different, something else here. We see that He was saying, bring 7 priests, bring 7 trumpets, the seventh day. There's something about this 7. Number 7 in the Bible is the number of completeness. The world was made in 6 days, and the seventh day He rested. Praise the name of the Lord. We all know the story of Naaman, the general from Syria, the general that came to Elisha. You know, when he came, first he went to the king. But because he believed, because he's a great man, a king is the one who can give him healing. But he was told that there is a prophet who can give you the healing. When he went to Elisha, Elisha sent a messenger to go and tell him, go and dip yourself in the river of Jordan 7 times and you're going to be healed. Do you think the Lord needed 7 times for him to be healed? He needed him. Do you think the Lord wanted him to punish him for 7 times? No. It was obedience. He wanted for him to obey, to see. And because he was a big general, he was like offended to go, why go and dip myself in that dirty river? But here we see a servant who was believing the Lord tell him that if a prophet would have told you to do something great, he could have done it. But he tells you something simple. How many times we come in that decision? The Lord is telling you just walk this way. But you see, this is very simple and you try to go other ways. How many times we fail to reach in our destiny because we see it's a very easy way. I think there's something wrong with this easy way. But the Lord wants to use the easy way. He just told him, go and dip yourself 7 times. He didn't go and tell him, bring gold, do this sacrifice. He didn't tell him to do anything. Just go and wash yourself 7 times. And when he went down and dipped himself 7 times, On the seventh time is when he came up and all his leprosy has gone down. Praise the name of the Lord. The Lord wants our obedience. He wants us to be obedient of his word. Whatever he says, he can do it. He didn't do this to punish Naaman. He didn't do this to show others that you need to do seven times. People with leprosy can go and dip themselves seven times or 50 times, but nothing will happen. But the Lord, when he says something, he must do. In the book of, in the Gospel of John, we see the seven I am. The Lord has the seven promises that the Lord has given to us. In John 6 and 35, can you please put that 635? And Jesus said unto them, I am the bread of life. Who comes to me shall never hunger, and he believe in me shall never thirst. That's the first promise that the Lord gave us. And the bread of life. If you come to him, you never hunger and you never thirst. If you believe in his word, you have everything. Praise the name of the Lord. The second is then in John 8 and 12. Then Jesus spoke to them again, saying, I am the light of the world. He who follow me shall not walk in darkness, but have light of life. Praise the name of the Lord. Before we come to Christ, we are blind. We may see the things of the world as the world sees it. I can't see this chair. I can see Elizabeth and her friend. But when I'm baptized in the name of Jesus, something else opens up inside of me. The spiritual eyes. Praise the name of the Lord. The story of Elijah and Gehazi, Elijah prayed, open his spiritual eyes so he can see. We need the spiritual eyes of the Lord. He is our light. Without him, we can see only the darkness of this world. The people out there, they don't have hope. You can see, even this week with the fire, people are crying, the government is not helping us, the people are not helping us, but they forget. Did they ask the Lord? Did they call upon the name of the Lord? Yes. Praise the name of the Lord. The third thing the Lord tells us, I am the door, in John 10 and 9. I am the door. If anyone enter by me, he will be saved, and I'll go and will go in and out and found pasture. In John 10 and 9. He is the door of the salvation. Without him, we cannot go. If you are not baptized in the name of Jesus, you cannot enter. You cannot enter there. It does not matter what you do, how good you are, but if you are not baptized in the name of Jesus, you cannot enter. Because he said, I am the door. Praise the name of the Lord. The other is John 10 and 11. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives life to the sheep. He's the one who gives us the life. Before we come to the Christ, we don't have life. You can go to the parties, you can do all of these things. But what's the meaning of all of this? Nothing. Tomorrow you want to do them again. The next day you want to go and be drunk again. But when you come to Jesus, you have life. You're expecting something for tomorrow. You're expecting to go and see the Master. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. The fifth thing Jesus said in John 11 and 25. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He believe in me, though he may die, he shall live again. We have a promise that we will live. We have a promise that even if you die, the Lord will come and raise us up and go to heaven with him. Praise the name of the Lord. Who believes that even if whatever happened to this world, the Lord is still coming. Praise the name of the Lord. The sixth thing, in John 14 and 6, Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one come to the Father except through me. We need to know where we are going. If you are just going randomly, you will not reach where you are going. He has said, I am the way. The Lord is the only way. There is no other way.
Amen.
There is no other name given heaven or earth. Yes. People who will see salvation. No. Praise the name of the Lord. Yes. Only in the name of Jesus. When you are baptized in the name of Jesus, you will see the salvation and you will see the heaven open for you. Yes. Praise the name of the Lord. The seventh thing Jesus said in John is John 15:1. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. If you abide in him, he will abide in you. We are the branches. He is the true vine, and we are the branches. We need to abide ourselves unto the Lord. We need to cling ourselves unto the Lord with everything we have. Especially in these last hours, in these last days, the enemy is knocking in every way. The enemy is knocking especially to the children of the Lord. The enemy bring temptation. The enemy bring good things. The enemy does not only bring bad things, can bring even good things. Maybe you don't have money or you don't have car. The enemy can bring you a car and that car is to destroy you. So don't be deceived about the things of the enemy. We know that he will come, the wolf will come dressed like a sheep. Be aware who are you listening to. Be aware on who are you seeing. Be aware in what you are believing. It's time to go back to the word of the Lord. Let us believe the word of the Lord and nothing more. Because the Lord. Our Lord is so good.
Amen.
Praise the Lord of the Lord.
Amen.
Other times the Lord challenges us. When Peter was asking how many times I need to forgive someone, he was told 70 times 7 in a day. Not in a year, in a day. So if a brother or sister wrong you, you need to forgive him because I don't think someone can wrong you for 490 times. It's very difficult. So you see, number 7 in the Bible has a lot of meaning. So let us remember this. Before the completion of the Lord come in number 7, there is number 6. We must through number 6. Number 6 is the number of the man. Before your victory come, the enemy will try to destroy you. The enemy will come and give you discouragement. The enemy will come and pull you down. But if you endure, the morning will come and it will be a joyful morning. Praise the name of the Lord. Before the wall of Jericho fall, they needed to walk. They needed to go round and round. It was not easy for them. It was a tiresome act to do. And on the seventh day, they needed to go 7 times. It was a tiresome, but because of the obedience, because of the strength of the Lord, the walls fall down. So even for you, whenever you're going through, whatever you see, the walls are rising up on you. Sometimes you can see a wall rising and after another one and another one and another one. Just remember where the Lord is taking you. He has a land full of milk and honey. That's supposed to be a focus. Pray for you, name of the Lord. Before they go to see the land of milk and honey, they need to pass Jericho. They need to pass a mighty army and a mighty force so they can reach the milk and honey. And because of them passing from Jericho, all the others, they fear them. They saw that their Lord is mighty. They saw that their Lord is great. There is nothing he is not able to do. You know, the Amorites and the rest, they heard that he has passed the sea. But they didn't saw the power of the Lord yet. But when the walls fall down and Jericho fall down without even a battle, they saw that the Lord can destroy their city even before before the children of Israel came. That's what the Lord is trying to tell us today. That today you are facing a battle, but that battle is for you to open the doors for the rest. Whenever you see a wall before you, that wall is to open the door for the next one. Praise the name of the Lord. Let us believe that the Lord is able to do whatever he said. Let us believe that the Lord has overcome this world and there is nothing that he cannot overcome. When I was going to my first mission trip to Corfu, and I went with the bus to Corfu. When I went there, in the bus, Bishop sent me a message. Very simple message. And I have overcome them. Because greater is he that is in you than he that's in the world. Praise the name of the Lord. Today I want to tell you, greater is he that is in you than he of the world. You may be sick, may be sick, but greater is he that is in you than in the world. You may go a financial problem, but greater is he that is in you than is in the world. You may be have a family problem, but greater is he that is in you than he that's in the world. Whatever you're going through, brethren, whatever you're going through, just remember who is inside of you. Who inside of you? Just remember that he is greater than of this world. He is greater than anything of this world. He has raised from the dead. And he is the one who gives life. So there is nothing he cannot do. Praise the name of the Lord. The wind obeys him. The storm obeys him. Even the walls obey him. So there is nothing he cannot do. His name is above every name. His name is above every situation. His name is above everything that we are going through. Praise the name of the Lord. Can we rise up? When the Lord was on the cross and he said, it's finished. The enemy thought that it's finished. He thought that everything has finished. He has conquered everything. But he forgot one thing. On the third day, he rose again. On the third day, he rose again. And when that day he rose again, he came and being glorified. On the morning on the third day, he rose again and he overcome the death once and for all. He overcome every problem that you're going to go through once and for all. Just believe in him. Be baptized in the name of Jesus. And you're going to see the door open for you. You're going to see the walls falling down. You're going to see like Joshua. Joshua was seeing the land of milk and honey. He was not seeing the walls of Jericho. He was seeing the land of milk and honey. So when we go before the Lord, let us see the land of milk and honey. And let us not see the problems and the situation we have in front of us. Praise the name of the Lord. Let us believe that the Lord can do whatever he said in the promises the Lord has given us. There is nothing you have gone through that is not written here in the word of the Lord. And he has given a promise that whatever you're going through, I'll stand you in everything you do. Let's today, whoever has a problem, whoever has a need, the altar is open. Just come and lay your problem unto the Lord. See the Lord. Lord, I want to see the milk and honey. I may have a great Jericho, I may have a great world in front of me, but I want to see you. I want to hear from you. I want your report, oh Lord Jesus. Can we pray? Oh Lord Jesus, Haya Rabasa, Haya Rabasa, Kaya Rabasa, oh Yoroboshi, Nayara Rabasa, Kaya Yara, oh your mighty God, oh Lord Jesus. I give you all the glory, Father. Give you the honor, Father. Thank you, Lord, for your word, oh Lord Jesus. Thank you for your miracle you're going to do, oh Lord Jesus. Thank you for the healing you're going to do, oh Lord Jesus. Thank you for the supreme glory, Father, for there is none like you. There is nothing impossible unto you, oh Lord Jesus. You are overcome, oh Lord Jesus. And we give you all the praise, oh Lord. Thank you for your everything, oh Lord Jesus. I worship you and give you all the glory.